Hello everybody, in today's lecture we'll be talking about clinical trials and what exactly happens during a clinical trial. To begin with, we should know what exactly is a clinical research. Any kind of a research that involves humans is considered clinical research. If it is specifically any kind of a medical research, then it is for sure a clinical research. This clinical research can be of two types. The first type are known as the observational studies, where the volunteers are observed in particular settings which may help identify new possibilities for clinical trials. Nextly, we have the clinical trials where research studies are performed on volunteers with an aim to evaluate a medical, surgical or behavioral intervention, which could be in the form of a drug or a device or a protocol. So when we move further into clinical trials, we should know why they are conducted. Clinical trials are the primary ways to find out if a new treatment, like that of a new drug or a dietary regimen or a medical device, is safe and effective for human usage. And usually, such clinical trials are used to learn if a new treatment is more effective and has got lesser side effects than a treatment that is already existent, which we call as a standard treatment. Or such clinical trials might be of diagnostic or preventive importance, where they could be providing insights about how to diagnose a disease quicker than the standard protocols that exist, or how to prevent a disease from occurring. And sometimes such clinical trials will be helpful for the patient attenders or the caregivers also, where it will emphasize on the role of such caregivers or support groups in the patient mental and physical well-being. Now moving on to the phases of clinical trials. In any case, clinical trials occur through four phases. And most importantly, they will be to test a treatment, to standardize the dosage of the treatment, and also to look for side effects. When you are testing a treatment, you will check if a drug is effective. And when you are standardizing the dosage, you will check at what concentration this drug is effective and not harmful to the patient. This is important, standardization of the dosage, because you will have to identify that dosage at which the drug actually acts. If it is lesser this dosage, the drug might not be effective. Or if it is greater to this dosage, the drug might actually be harmful to the person consuming it. And lastly, clinical trials across the phases will help us look for side effects. So here, while looking for side effects also, each of these phases will have different parameters. Parameters in terms of the population that is being treated or the time of exposure to this population with the drug. So either way, you will get a better idea on how this drug can act adversely, and which is that particular population group or that particular exposure time which will bring about these adverse effects of the drug on the volunteers. And only if any drug is found effective in the first three phases, it will be sent for an approval. Where generally the Food and Drug Administration, be it of the United States of America, US FDA is supposed to be the most well-known FDA organization, and most of the drugs that are consumed throughout the world are generally approved by the US FDA. Otherwise, there could be individual FDAs in each of the countries as well. And these FDAs also can provide approvals, but US FDA approval is the highest approval any drug maker can get, and this is the ultimate authority to provide such approvals. So once this approval for clinical use is obtained, there will be monitoring of its effects for a longer term. And usually, whenever a drug is marketed or it is taken up for trials, such drugs of clinical trials will be described according to their phase. So the person who is taking it up must know at which phase this drug is being tested. Like for example, we had the Covaxin vaccine by Bharat Biotech that was in clinical trials lately. So whenever a mention of Covaxin was made, it was clearly highlighted that it was a phase 3 drug or a phase 3 vaccine that was being provided. So whenever a clinical trial is being happening, it is understood that the phase 1, phase 2 or phase 3 label must be there. Whereas phase 4 label need not be there because it has gotten approval, and any drug that is in the market is generally in its fourth phase of clinical trial. And typically the US FDA will require the phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3 trials to be conducted to determine if the drug can be approved for use. Now talking about each phase, generally a phase 1 trial tests an experimental treatment on a small group of usually healthy people. And this small group will have about 20 to 80 people in it. And this will be to judge its safety and side effects. And also carry out the standardization of the drug dosage. So the emphasis here in the case of phase 1 trial will be purely on the safety of the drug. They won't look categorically on how the drug acts on people and how it alleviates a disease, but the investigations will be to look on how the drug will act on people and how it can cause adverse effects in the population that has been treated. And while doing this, standardization of the drug dosage can also be carried out in the phase trial. And thereby the emphasis of a phase 1 trial is purely on the safety of the test drug. And it is carried out on a small group of people who are healthy. Next will be the phase 2 trial, where the population that is treated with the drug in phase 2 trial will generally be greater than the population of the phase 1 trial. Here it could be 100 to 300 persons as a part of the trial, and the emphasis of phase 2 trial will be on the effectiveness of the drug. So when we talk of effectiveness, it clearly indicates that it aims to obtain preliminary data on whether the drug can work on people who have certain disease or condition. This is the second difference that you can find between the phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 had healthy people and a smaller group, whereas phase 2 will have diseased people or diseased volunteers of a larger group. And the third difference will be that while the phase 1 looks out for the safety of the drug, the phase 2 will look into the effectiveness or efficiency or efficacy of the drug. Also, a phase 2 trial will simultaneously continue to study the safety, where it will also look into the short-term side effects of the drug. And a phase 2 trial can last for several years, given the fact that it is conducted on diseased populations and on a larger population, of course. So it could take some time to be carried out. Nextly, we have the phase 3 trial, which focuses gathering more information on both the safety and efficacy of the drug. And in order to establish this, a phase 3 trial will be studying different populations with different doses. So, it could be healthy population and diseased population of volunteers who are tested with multiple doses. So, thereby there are different cohorts or groups that are present within the test groups. And also, the population could be varied, where it could contain people of different ethnicity, where people who are Asian, people who are American, people who are African, Australian and European could be part of the study group, and tests will be carried out on each of this group to see on how effective or how risky the treatment can be to individual group. Simultaneously, there will be treatment carried out in combinations also, where the drug is given in combination to other standard drugs to see if there can be an improvement in the efficacy of the standard drug or the test drug that is being carried out, or to see on how the delivery of the test drug can be improvised with the use of a standard drug, or to see on how the adverse effects or the adverse events that can occur due to the treatment of the test sample can be reduced with the use of a standard drug. Like for example, in a daily situation, when you visit a doctor for to get treatment for a particular type of pain, whenever a painkiller is given, the physician will also prescribe an antacid tablet or an anti-gastric tablet, gastritis tablet, along with the painkiller. And this is mainly to subside the gastritis that is caused due to the consumption of the painkiller. So here, that will be a successful combination that has evolved over the period of time. Likewise, using of test drug in combination will help the researchers find out if the side effects of the test drug can be alleviated with the help of a standard drug. And also in phase 3 trial, the number of volunteers on who this experiment will be conducted will be bigger, where it could range from several hundreds to about 3,000 people. And only if the phase 3 trial results are positive can we have the approval of the FDA to utilize this experimental drug or device in clinical settings or to bring them to market. And finally, we have the phase 4 trial, where the phase 4 trial takes place only after the FDA has given approval for the usage of the test drug or device, which will now be considered an approved drug or device. It will not anymore be a test drug. But the phase 4 trial will look into the effectiveness and safety of the approved drug or device, and it will be monitored on large and diverse populations for the side effects, because these side effects may not become clear until more people have taken the treatment or more people have been exposed to the therapy or to the drug for over a longer period of time. So, for clinical trial number 4 or the fourth phase of clinical trial will make sure that the long-term effects of a drug are also taken into consideration before it can be finally approved completely as a standard drug. So this is the pictorial representation of the clinical trial phases, where at phase 1 there are usually a maximum of 100 healthy volunteers, and this phase 1 will focus on the dose finding and safety of the individual. And nextly, it will once everything is successfully carried out in phase 1, there will be phase 2 that is conducted on 100 to 300 patients, looking for the efficacy of the treated drug. Here it is healthy volunteers, whereas here it is patients. And here it is a lookout for efficacy, and secondly the safety of the drug, because safety is already confirmed here. And then in the case of phase one, since it is for safety, they use healthy volunteers. Whereas in the case of phase two, since it is for efficacy, they use patients. This is because if the drug can be safe for healthy volunteers, then it can be possibly safe for the patients also. Whereas you cannot necessarily differentiate the adverse effects that are caused in patients. And now, after the phase 2 trial is successfully completed, the phase 3 trial will be initiated, and this will be for a larger cohort of 300 to 3000 patients. Here again, it is tested for efficacy and safety, and the patient population is diverse here. So, there could be a larger group of population from different countries, and the efficacy and safety will be tested alongside, sometimes in combination with the other standard drugs. And after the phase 3 is completed, there will be regulatory submission where the drug will be sent for approval by FDA or the EMA. And once the FDA approval is obtained, the drug will be out in the market. And here is the post-marketing approval surveillance studies in the form of phase 4 trials carried out. And finally, once all this is successfully completed, and the drug, if it does not show any long-term side effects or implications, the drug can be considered a standard drug. So with this, I would like to conclude today's lecture. Thank you all.